Okay guys, well welcome back. Today we're going to go over the Anderson Powerpole. You saw these in a prior video and they're basically the 12 volt connector of choice. And I thought I would go over how to install them and also some accessories that you can use with the Anderson Powerpole. Now the Anderson Powerpoles that are going to be most commonly used, especially in the amateur radio setting, are going to be the 45 amp, 30 amp, and these are 15 amp. And basically, the housing is all the same. The only thing that varies is the size of the connector that goes in the housing. So on this side, 15 amp, 30 amp, 45 amp. And as you go up in amperage, of course, the wire size goes up, and accordingly, the size of the connector goes up so you can fit the wire in. But the tongue on the end is the same, and that fits in the Anderson Powerpole.
Okay, the basic structure of the Anderson Powerpole is centered around these plastic housings. And the housings are basically the same. In fact, they're exactly the same except for the color. They both have on two sides, see if I can get a reflected light, a dovetail fitting that's molded in, and on the other two sides, a dovetail recess. Now the mnemonic to remember is red on right, both starting with an R, so red on right, and tongues up. And it's hard to see in the camera, but inside there's a little metallic tongue, and the tongue on the connector is going to be facing up, and that's the orientation so that it can dovetail with the connector on the inside. Sounds complicated, but it's actually very simple. So red on right, tongues up, so these top parts with the metal tongue is up, and that's also the same orientation for this little metal connector. Now, in this orientation, you'll notice on the red is a dovetail, and on the black is a recess. See that in the reflected light? And these basically fit together, and then you slide them together, and there's the connector. Now the nice thing about these is you can configure any array that you want by just stacking more up on these interfacing dovetails. But for most of the 12 volt work that we're going to do, it's just going to be a positive and a negative connector.
Now so you'll notice that there's a small hole where the two come together. That is where this little roll pin goes. You just push it in the hole, and that essentially locks these two pieces together. You notice on this extension cable that I made that I've got the roll pins installed. On this power supply for my radio, you'll notice I have an adapter that's plugged into those holes. It's a little hard to see black on black, but let's take a look on red on black. And that basically has two pins that push into those two holes without the roll pin. And then these two barbs on either end lock onto the end of the Anderson Powerpole, effectively locking the two together. Now the only thing I did for mine is I clipped those tabs off and I held it in place with a zip tie. That way if I want to quickly unhook this,
well,
I can do that.
Talking accessories,
here's another nifty accessory. This is a weatherproof cap. They're about $1, $1.50. I picked up four at a recent ham fest, and here you can see it installed on the end of the Anderson Powerpole connector. Now I put it on this set because this cable set is going to be mounted in my truck. Red to positive, black to negative, two sets of fuses, and this will give me a very easily accessible 12 volt Powerpole connection for my radio should I need it while I'm out with my truck. So that's a pretty nifty little set up. Some easily made accessories that use Anderson power poles, some spare wire, and some bits and pieces. I've got a pair of battery clamps that I can plug in, and I have a pair of wire clamps that I can also plug in with the Anderson power pole, and they just basically go together pretty simply as you've seen. Now I can plug those in to this 12-foot roll
basically an extension cord, and now I've got quite a bit of capability.
What I need to make
right
now
is a set of cables that will allow me to hook into my power supply, plug-in power supply, and Anderson Powerpole connectors so that I can plug into my radio. Let's go ahead and make that connection.
What we're going to need is a wire stripper,
an Anderson Powerpole crimper. Now you can use basically any crimper will work, but I've just found this gives me more consistent results, and it was well worth the investment of about $30. A wire cutter, a heat gun. You can also use a lighter or butane torch, some heat shrink tubing, some wire, Anderson Powerpole connectors, and the little roll pin. Now, one extra modification that I'm going to show you that I do is I form a strain relief by putting some Mason cord whipping underneath a piece of shrink tubing, and that basically gives good strain relief from these wires pulling apart and will add to durability
of this
accessory.
The first thing we're going to do is strip about a quarter of an inch off the end of the wire.
And these automatic strippers just make that a very easy task. Then you want to just gently twist those wires so they make a nice firm bundle. That'll make it easier to install into the Anderson PowerPole clip.
Okay, the next step is to insert the wire into the end of the Anderson PowerPole clip.
And you want to make sure that all the wire is inside that ferrule. Then you take your crimpers. And these crimpers are nice because they include 15, 30, and 45 amp connectors all in one tool. Now you orientate your clip at the end so that it's sitting like that, and it will sit inside. It's kind of hard to see if I can get the right light, but inside on the top of that anvil is a small little housing, and you just basically slide it in and then you crimp down. And basically with this particular crimper, you just crimp until the handle gives way, and then it's done. You got to be careful. If you go too hard, the instructions say you can break the anvil, but I've really found this very easy to use. You just squeeze, and at a certain point it gives way, and then it's done. And that gives you a very nice crimp on the end of the wire.
Basically,
and that's
all you
just feed
need.
It in, and there'll be a very satisfying click, and that wire now is in there. All right, I'm going to complete the black one, and then we'll finish this accessory.
There we have it. The Anderson PowerPole, we got the wires crimped on and into their housings.
We'll put the little roll pin in 1 second. Now you saw how I did this. I was using two separate wires. One little bit of advice: when you're using red and black zip cord, you want to make sure that when you look at the ends, that the Anderson PowerPole clips are exactly parallel. If one is twisted or canted, it'll make it very difficult to slide it into the back of the housing. So you want to hold that wire flat as it enters the crimper and keep that same orientation when you do the opposite wire. And when you look at them, the blades should be parallel to each other. If they're slightly off, you can just gently twist a little bit and that'll help. But the more you keep them straight, the easier it will be to mount them in the connector.
Okay, well, there is the roll pin started in the housing, and what I found easiest for me is to start it, and then I use the end of a pair of scissors to gently push that pin in so that it's flush, and then I take the very tip of the scissor and gently push it just below the surface, and you'll notice that it's just below the surface on both sides. And I think that makes a nice installation.
Okay, guys. Well, I put shrink tubing in the same category as duct tape, super glue, and epoxy, stuff that you have to have on hand. We're going to make the strain relief on this cable with a full length of 3/8 shrink tubing and half a length of 1/2 inch shrink tubing.
All right.
Well, we begin by sliding the 3/8 onto the wire and bring it all the way up to the end of the Anderson power pole. Then we're going to take our heat gun and shrink that down. Now, there's a number of options you can do. You can certainly take a zip tie and strap it around there. That'll work very effectively. A modification that I've come up with uses about a 3-foot piece of mason cord. About a 1-foot piece like that and put a fold in it. So you'll notice that we've got a short piece and a long piece. I will orientate the loop backwards from where I'm going to start. I'll keep the line flat, put my thumb down to lock it in place, and I'm going to start about a 1/4 inch back. So I'm going to leave the short piece alone, and I'm going to take the long piece, and I'm basically going to start wrapping. I'm going to put 6 wraps. So there's 1
coming around. 2.
I'll put my index finger right there to hold it in place, and I'm going to take that piece and bring it up through the bottom of the loop and bring it tight. And now I'm going to put my other index finger on that side, holding that in place. So you can see that I've got the loop with that cord coming up through it. And basically, if you get the idea here, I can pull the short one and tighten up this loop like that. Now, if you pull hard enough, I'm going to pull the loop underneath these wrappings, which will make
that
a nice, secure
loop
now in the middle. And if I pull tight, that gives a very solid whipping right around that heat shrink tubing and provides a nice strain relief for these two cables. Now, to finish it off, we're going to clip off the ends of the
scissors.
Cord. Clip. And we take our 1/2 inch tubing, slide it on, and I bring it right even, and we'll shrink that down. All right, there you have it. So we've got an Anderson power pole, strain relief. And in this case, I've got 2 wire ends that have been tinned with solder that will plug into my switching plug-in power supply for my radio.
This should give you an idea of the flexibility of Anderson PowerPole.
So this is a pigtail off the end of my 12-volt battery. There is an accessory cable made to go into a switching power supply. There is the power cord to my radio with Anderson power poles and fuses, an Anderson power pole connector for an automobile 12-volt battery, a 12-volt extension cord with Anderson power poles on both ends, a set of wire clips, and a set of battery clips. And trust me, this is just scratching the surface.